Government's response towards the quality of milk on the market follows a video which has been making rounds on social media where an interviewee claimed that some milk on the Ugandan market is unsafe and the supervision in the dairy sector is inadequate. Dr. Michael Kansime, the executive director of the Dairy Development Authority, says such reckless statements hurt the economy, insists that the milk on the market is safe for consumption and encouraged the public to take it.
Retire it. Drink more milk. Give your children more milk. Our milk is safe, secure, and is of high standards. Our per capita consumption for milk is still the lowest, almost the lowest in the region. Every person, according to WHO, should take 200 liters of milk annually. But for us, we take only 63.
Milk production in the country has increased from 2.08 billion litres in 2015 to 2.8 billion litres annually, and 80.2% of this is marketed.
We have milk 7.4 and we have transported now 2.8. That means there is still a gap for investment. For some of you who make your money, this is an area to invest.
A tremendous improvement in milk collection and bulking with a number of players has also been achieved. The authority currently has 198 registered roadworthy milk tankers of different capacities operating countrywide. However, in recent reports, milk adulteration remains a challenge facing the industry, but Kansime says they have put in place new measures to control the vice.
Major focus, we spend almost over 70% on training the farmer to produce clean milk. Two, inspection of milk handling premises. Every premise where milk is sold, vended, including supermarkets, the shelves, we inspect them, look at the expiry periods, see where they conform with quality.
With research showing 2.4 million children in the country facing stunted growth due to poor nutrition, parents have been encouraged to give their children more milk for proper growth. Uganda's per capita milk consumption is still the lowest in the region and stands at 63 liters, which falls below the 200 liters recommended by the World Health Organization. Report by Jaliet Namwaya for the news.